Let's talk about solving what are called absolute value equations. Now, all an absolute value equation is simply an equation with an absolute value in it. Okay, so first I'd like you to consider the following idea. So let's say you want to consider this. Let's say I took the absolute value of something and I said that that was equal to 7. So I didn't tell you what this was, but I told you the absolute value of it was 7. Well, you'd conclude one of two things, right? That whatever's inside the absolute value symbols, there are only two possibilities. Either 7, because the absolute value of 7 is 7, but there's another possibility as well, right? What's in here could also be, let me go ahead and circle that so you know what I'm talking about, right? That could also be negative 7. So if you put a 7 or a negative 7 in there, you get a true statement, because the absolute value of either one of these is positive 7. Okay, so let's take that logic and solve an absolute value equation now. So let's go ahead and solve. How about the absolute value of x minus 5 is equal to 8? Now, the same logic applies because at the end of the day, you're taking the absolute value of something. So this whole thing, let me circle that there. That whole thing, right? They're only one of two options. Well, either the whole thing is either equal to 8, or the whole thing is equal to negative 8, right? Because only when you take the absolute value of 8 or negative 8 do you get positive 8. So either, let's write that down. Either x minus 5 is equal to 8, right? Or x minus 5 is equal to negative 8. So you take the whole thing inside the absolute value symbol, symbols, and you set it equal to either positive 8 or negative 8. And then you solve these resulting equations. Now, these equations, notice, don't have the absolute value symbol anymore. That's the whole point of doing this. It's a way of getting rid of the absolute value symbols. Now, these equations we know how to solve, right? I'm simply going to add 5 to both sides for the first one. So I get x is equal to 13. That's one possibility. Or the second possibility, if I add 5 to both sides, is that x is equal to, well, negative 3. And those would be my answers, 13 or negative 3. Now let's check one of them just to make sure they really work. So for example, take negative 3 for x. If you take that negative 3 and you plug it in right here, well, you take negative 3 and subtract 5, and that's negative 8. But then when you take the absolute value of that, you get positive 8. Okay, so that's how it works. Once you have the absolute value isolated, you play this game with the right-hand side. Let's try another one like that. Okay, so this one's a little more complicated because the absolute value is not by itself, right? So the first step is always to get the absolute value isolated. So let me write that down. You always want to isolate the absolute value. Okay, that's always your first step. Now, how do you do that? It turns out that you have to be really careful here because this really right here is 2 times the absolute value of x plus 1. It's kind of like having this. It's like having 6 minus 2 times y equals negative 12. And if somebody asked you to get the y by itself, what would you first do? Well, you wouldn't subtract 2 from 6, right? You wouldn't do this because of order of operations. You'd first have to subtract 6 from both sides. And that's why over here we have to first subtract the 6 from both sides, because the absolute value of x plus 1 is like our y. Right? We're handling those algebraically in the same way. So we're going to subtract 6 from both sides. And what does that give us? Let's see. We're going to get, well, these cancel. That's why we did it. So it's negative 2, absolute value of x plus 1 is equal to negative 18. And it's kind of like having over here, right? If you subtracted 6 from both sides, you'd have negative 2y equals negative 18. Now let me ask you, what would you do over here? Well, yeah, you'd divide both sides by negative 2. Same thing here, right? Divide both sides by the negative 2, and because it's multiplication here, those are going to cancel, like so. And then we have the absolute value of x plus 1 is equal to, well, positive 9 on the right-hand side. Okay, now once you've got it down to this stage, now you can do what we said earlier. That is, what's inside the absolute value symbols is either positive 9 or negative 9. Let's write that down. X plus 1 is either equal to 9 or x plus 1 is equal to negative 9. Now, I should just say that we're going to see an example in a moment where the right-hand side, once you've isolated the absolute value, where the right-hand side is not positive. If it's not positive, you don't do this. This only works out, or you only do it this way when you've isolated the absolute value and the right-hand side is a positive number. Okay, so let's go ahead and finish this one off. So subtracting 1 from both sides. So we have x is either equal to 8, or subtracting 1 from both sides, we get x is equal to negative 10. So these would be our answers, 8 or negative 10. Okay, let's try another one like that, or that illustrates the point I was mentioning a moment ago. Okay, let's solve. Negative 2 times the absolute value of x plus 4 is equal to positive 10. Okay, so once again, your first step is always isolate the absolute value. So this case, in this problem, we're going to divide both sides by negative 2. And the negative 2s are going to cancel, right? And you get this. The absolute value of x plus 4 is equal to negative 5. Now, the right-hand side is not positive. So at this stage, we already isolated the absolute value. And once you do that and the right-hand side is not positive, don't do what you did a moment ago for the following reason. If I told you the absolute value of something was equal to, let's say, negative 3. Well, think about that for a second, right? We know that the absolute value of something, right? Absolute value of anything is always greater than or equal to 0. So this right here, right? That's always greater than or equal to 0 because the last thing you're doing is taking the absolute value. How can something that's greater than or equal to 0 ever be equal to negative 3? It can't be, right? This is never true. And that's the logic over here. The left-hand side of the equation, right? Yeah, you add 4 to x, but at the end of the day, you take the absolute value. That's the final operation you're performing, and that operation always is going to give you a number that's greater than or equal to 0. It can never be equal to negative 5, no matter what x you start with, right? Whenever the last thing you do is take the absolute value, you always get something greater than or equal to 0, never negative. This is impossible, so there's no solution. Okay, so only when you have the absolute value being equal to a positive do you do it like we did a moment, like we handled the previous problems. When the absolute value is equal to a negative, you get no solution. Okay, and that's how you solve absolute value equations.